Esteemed member of this august house, today I rise here to speak on the union budget that was presented by the honorable finance minister yesterday. If I am to describe this budget in one line, I would say it's a budget without any clarity or vision, which has been rolled out to satisfy the coalition partners of the BJP rather than providing any substantial relief to the 140 crore people of this country. This budget was planned by two individuals to keep another two in good faith, neglecting the aspiration of 140 crore people. So the gist is, it has been planned by two and executed for two. It's an anti-people budget crafted to bribe two political parties and buy time before the government implodes. So today we stand at the precipice of a new era in Indian democracy. When PM Modi became the Prime Minister for the first time in 2014, everyone referred to that government as Modi government. When Mr. Modi was elected for a second term in 2019, everyone referred to that term as Modi 2.0. But on June 4, 2024, the people of India decisively rejected the Modi-led BJP government, which reigned supreme almost for a decade. What we now have in place is a creaky, shaky coalition. Yes, sir, coalition. Sir, coalition means cooperation. And no one is referring to this government as Modi 3.0, not even the Union Finance Minister who presented the budget yesterday, not even the MPs of the BJP, neither the Home Minister, nor the External Affairs Minister, nor the Defence Minister, nor the Panchayat Minister, nor the Health Minister, no one, sir. Even the BJP leaders are not referring to this as Modi 3.0. Sir, it's so uncertain and fragile that it can implode any time. Sir, as I was saying, coalition means cooperation. Coalition means collaboration. Coalition means cohesion. But after yesterday, one thing is very clear, sir, that coalition means appeasement and compensation. So that is very clear from the yesterday's budget. It's ironic that BJP, which decried of appeasement politics in the last 10 years, is now ensnared in its tentacles, as in the appeasement politics tentacles, trying to save its own chair. Waqt badal gaya, sir. This change is more than a paradigm shift in leadership. It's a clear rejection of authoritativeness. It's a rejection of arrogance, divisive politics, and empty promises. The message from the electorate of this country is loud and clear. Waqt badal gaya hai. Today is exactly 50 days since the rejection. But PM Modi refuses to accept the reality. He's running a coalition government and he wants everyone to believe that sab changa si. Everything is good. So the defense minister is the same, the commerce minister is the same, the home minister is the same, the external affairs minister is the same, the finance minister is also same. Sir, one thing has changed. I was sitting throughout when the budget was being read. Only the cheerleaders have gone down in numbers. Wo bench bajane walon ka thoda number kamti ho gaya hai. The number of cheerleaders have gone down because the people of this country denied them an access to this temple of democracy, sir. This is a big change. Amidst all the failures in the last decade, the PM and his government achieved something truly remarkable. A world-class collection of abbreviations. With more than 110 acronyms or abbreviations up their sleeve. Every new initiative feels like almost a linguistic surprise. Who need plain names, sir, when you can have a whole vocabulary of letters to decipher? 110 names, just imagine. And why I'm talking about abbreviations or acronyms? Because I want to reply to this government in a language they understand. Sir, from ART, ART means accountability, responsibility, transparency, to RIDAY, which means Heritage Development and Augmentation Yojana, to UDAN, which means Ude Desh Ke Aam Nagarik, to GOBAR, which means Galvanizing Organic Bio Agro Resources. They have thrown every absurd acronym possible at the people of this country. 110 names. And like I said, I want to reply to this government in a language that this government and the union minister, especially the union finance minister, understand. So budget, B-U-D-G-E-T, it has 6 letters. And I will explain all 6 letters in details. So let me start with B. B for betrayal. BJP promised Achhe Din. BJP promised Achhe Din before coming to power. BJP promised Achhe Din before coming to power in 2014, sir. Sir, what has they done? What has they done? They have betrayed the citizens. They have betrayed the housewives, betrayed daily wage earners, betrayed farmers. Sunne ka himmat rakhiye. Sunne ka himmat rakhiye. Sir, price rise. Price rise. Sir, a home cooked veg thali costs 8% more year on year. In April 2024, onions are up by 43%, 41%, and potatoes 39%.
Hey, Nirmala Sitharaman bolte kintu. Nirmala Sitharaman bolte na mana. Ekdam bolte na mana Nirmala Sitharaman. Ekdam. Bhai jaye unko.
Sir, I have a lot of patience.
Please, Dara, bete.
So these things will not distract me. You can just ask them to have patience and listen to what I say. And then the minister can reply. He is not going to become the minister. This is not going to score in brownie points.
Please.
Sir, BJP promised Achhe Din before coming to power in 2014. But what has they done? Betrayed citizen, betrayed housewives, betrayed daily wage earners, betrayed farmers. Sir, price rise. A home cooked veg thali costs 8% more year on year in April 2024. Onions are up by 43%. Tomatoes, 41%. Potatoes, 39%. LPG gas, cylinders prices cross 1100 in 2023. Household savings plummeted to a 50-year low in 2023, with household debt reaching a record high of 39.1% of GDP in 2024. Sir, in case of earnings, 63 crore people earn less than 308 rupees a day, and 18 crore people earn less than 180 rupees a day. If the NDA government in the last 10 years had spent even a quarter of time it dedicated to political witch hunting and spreading communal hatred on addressing the real issue for the interest of the people, India would not be ranking 111th out of 125 countries in the Global Hunger Index. This people sitting here in the treasury bench needs to know. So they betrayed the marginalized communities. They spoke about Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, which turned into Jo Hamare Saath, Hum Unke Saath, as admitted by BJP MLA and the leader of opposition in Bengal Assembly, and proved right by the failed finance minister of this failed government yesterday. It's a crime against scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, increased by 13% and 14% respectively from 2021 to 2023. Uttar Pradesh, they speak about double engine government. They are trying to defame Bengal. But let me give you a data which was given by the Social Empowerment Justice Ministry last year, which was given by the minister himself in Rajya Sabha in June 2023, which proves that Uttar Pradesh have the highest number of cases of atrocities against Dalit,
yes,
followed by Rajasthan. Sir, who is in power in Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan? Can these two who are shouting at the top of their voices answer? Who is the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh? Who is the Chief Minister of Rajasthan? After the Mangal Sutra and Mujra. Sir, after the Mangal Sutra and Mujra vilification episode, the government of Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand, in their infinite wisdom, have mandated that eateries along with the Kavar Jatra route display the name of owners and staff members, a move clearly intended to instigate hate speeches and hate crimes targeting the minority community. We commend and thank the Honorable Supreme Court for swiftly intervening with a stay order against all these discriminatory directives. Sir, vacancies in tribal schools, 10,000 vacancies still lying left in Eklavya school, residential school, remains unfilled as of today. Sir, religious representation. Sir, religion belongs to an individual, whereas a festival is for everyone. Like the Honorable Chief Minister of West Bengal has said, Dharmo Jar Jar, Utshob Shobar. BJP doesn't have a single Muslim MP. Sir, listen to this. The whole country needs to know that BJP doesn't have a single Muslim MP in Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, or any state assembly. Diversity isn't about the colors in our flag. It's about the people in our parliament. So the absence of diversity in parliament has tangible consequences in the past. It led to policies that overlooked the needs of marginalized communities, legislation that failed to address systematic injustices, and a governance structure that perpetuated inequality rather than fostering unity. The marginalized across the country have spoken with a strong voice this time and unequivocally rejected a government that has betrayed their aspiration and rights. So now I come to you. Budget ka B pe bola betrayal, ab U pe aata hoon. Sir, U stand for unemployment. Unemployment rate in our country rose to an 8-month high of 9.2% in June 2024. Sir, youth unemployment. Modi ji ki tisri baar, yuvak abhi bhi berozgar. Sir, when we speak about youth unemployment, sir, look what unemployment has done to this country. This is the perfect example. They've gone mad. This is what unemployment has done, sir.
Sir,
Modi ji ki tisri baar, yuvak abhi bhi berozgar.
एक मिनट, आप जैसे
आप जैसे सुन के आए हैं, ऐसे भी ये लोग भी सुन के आए हैं, तो नॉट इट से डर, तो आप थोड़ा सा इस पसा का देखो प्लीज।
मोदी जी की तीसरी बार
मोदी
जी की तीसरी बार युवक अभी भी बेरोजगार। सर अमंग ग्रेजुएट्स इट वॉज 13% इन 22-23, अमंग पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट्स एंड अबव इट वॉज 12.1% इन 22-23। द स्किल इंडिया मिशन एम टू ट्रेन 400 मिलियन पीपल बाय 2022 बट ओनली 14 मिलियन रिसीव ट्रेनिंग बाय 2024। The target still remains a distant dream. The Honorable Finance Minister announced 2 lakh crore package for 5 schemes on job and skilling of 4 crore 10 lakh youth. BJP had previously promised 2 crore jobs a year. They are nowhere close to meeting the target and now they are setting unrealistic targets. These young people don't want to listen to budget speeches. The young people of this country, the young India doesn't want to listen to your rhetoric, doesn't want to listen to your empty promises, doesn't want to listen to your 90 minute long budget speeches. They want jobs, J-O-B-S. So women unemployment rate for women living in urban India soared to 22.7%. Beti bachao, beti padhao. They forgot to mention about beti ko naukri dilao. On the other hand, you see what's happening in Bengal. Kanyashri scholarship scheme touched the lives of 85 lakh girls and won the UN Public Service Award. Sir, this award was not handed over by any Tom, Dick or Harry. It won the UN Public Service Award. Over 2 crore 20 lakh women have been financially empowered through schemes like Lakhir Bhandar. Financial assistance of 12,000 annually for general category and 14,400 for SC/ST women. Many other states are also rolling out similar schemes. So make it a national model. I'll appeal to the Honorable Finance Minister. I humbly urge the government to set aside arrogance and embrace willingness to learn from successful practices, integrating them into our approach. Sir, only 3 states in the country have enterprises where women own more than 3 out of 10 establishments. And these 3 states are Telangana, West Bengal, and Karnataka. It's not coincidental, sir, that all 3 states are governed by non-BJP political parties. And I have no qualms or hesitation in saying that BJP and women empowerment simply don't align and is rather paradoxical. So now I come to the deprive, like the honorable member has deprived. Yes. Sir, D for deprive. Yes. You spent 20,000 crore on revamping Central Vista. You did this. Abhishek, you did this to improve Abhishek, the homes please, of the rich.
Please listen.
Influential.
Please.
And powerful.
Abhishek, please.
What have you done
please.
For the homeless?
Please.
In the cities, in
jo,
the towns,
jo, please,
in the villages.
Abhishek, please listen. Jo is sadan ka, please. Ek minute. Jo is sadan ka member nahi hai, aap inka bare mein bol nahi sakta. Please. Ye sir. Sir, ek second nikal de sir. Please. Soumitra Khan ji. Soumitra Khan ji, please go to your seat, please. Dara, please. Soumitra Khan ji, please. Soumitra Khan ji, please. Soumitra Khan ji. Soumitra Khan ji. Aap log bhi baithe, aap log bhi baithe. Hum aasan se khada hoge aap.
Theek hai sir. Ye utar diji.
Please. Soumitra Khan ji.
चलिए मानिए मानिए प्लीज 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 माय प्लीज प्लीज कल्याण जी प्लीज आपके सदस्य बोल रहे हैं आपके सदस्य बोल रहे हैं प्लीज
एक चीज सर मैं एक चीज स्पष्ट कर देता हूँ सर चेयरमैन सर ने बोला जो एक, इस सदन एक, की मेंबर नहीं है
एक मिनट
सदस्य नहीं है
एक मिनट एक मिनट
सर एक बार सुन लीजिए
एक मिनट प्लीज माननीय सदस्य आप भी बैठ जाए एक मिनट माननीय सदस्यगण हमें ये प्रयास करना चाहिए कि जो इस सदन का सदस्य नहीं हो उसके बारे में टिप्पणी नहीं करें सभी लोग इसकी पालन करने का प्रयास करें
सर मैं एक
प्लीज प्लीज बोल दिया ना सबको
बोल दिया सर
नो हम लोग तो बोलते हैं बीजेपी लोग जब करते हैं आप लोग कुछ नहीं बोलते क्यों नहीं
एक मिनट
क्यों नहीं आप उनको नहीं बोलने देना चाहते आप उनको डिस्टरबेंस कर रहे हैं प्लीज अभिषेक जी एक मिनट अभिषेक जी एक मिनट मैंने सभी माननीय सदस्यों को आप डायरेक्शन देंगे क्या मुझे नो प्लीज बैठिए प्लीज माननीय ऐसे मत कीजिए प्लीज ऐसे माननीय सदस्य मेज मत थपाइए जब आपको बोल दिया बैठना है तो बैठना है अभिषेक जी
मैं एक चीज सर स्पष्ट करता हूँ ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन सर ने बोला जो इस सदन के सदस्य नहीं है कोई भी सदस्य उनके खिलाफ कोई टिप्पणी नहीं करेगा सर मैं आपसे इतना पूछना चाहता हूँ पश्चिम बंगाल के चीफ मिनिस्टर ममता बनर्जी सदन के सदस्य है नहीं है तो उन्होंने क्यों टिप्पणी किया सर आप अपना पद का मान रखिए सर उनको उठ के बोलिए माफी मांगेगा देन आई विल कंटिन्यू माई स्पीच नो सर यू हैव टू इंटरवीन सर यू आर द स्पीकर ऑफ दिस हाउस नो सर
एक मिनट प्लीज
मैं हाथ
जोड़ के ऐ बड़े जंतू
आमी
हाथ जंतू
आमी हाथ
बड़े प्लीज प्लीज प्लीज
आग्रह करता हूँ विनम्र रूप से मैं आग्रह करता हूँ सर उनको बोलिए आप स्पीकर के नाते अध्यक्ष के नाते
माननीय
सदन का गरीबा के लिए आप उनको बोलिए उठ के वो माफी मांगेगा
नहीं प्लीज प्लीज आपको कंटिन्यूस करना है तो करिए उनका नाम सदन के रिकॉर्ड से निकाल दिया है नहीं करना है तो आप डायरेक्शन मत दिए कि उनको माफी मांगे आप मुझे डायरेक्शन नहीं दे सकते मैंने उनका नाम निकाल दिया ऐसे कई बार हुआ है सदन में पहले निकाल दिया
सर डी फॉर डिप्राइव यू स्पेंड 2,000 crore ऑन रिवैम्पिंग सेंट्रल विस्टा यू डिड दिस टू इम्प्रूव द होम्स ऑफ द रिच influential and powerful what have you done for the homeless in the cities towns and villages why have you deprived the homeless across india and bengal you are not only visionless and shameless you are not
एक मिनट
सर ही इज नॉट इवन लिसनिंग टू यू
अब क्यों डिस्टर्ब मैं बाद में आपकी बात सुन लूंगा
सर ही
आपकी बात सुन लूंगा
सर सो
नहीं नहीं सब निकाल देंगे प्लीज सर, निकाल देंगे
उसको भी सर ये तो आपका बात भी नहीं सुन रहे डिप्राइविंग रूरल पुअर मोदी जी की तीसरी बार गरीबों के ऊपर लगातार अत्याचार सर ओवर द पास्ट डिकेड द बीजेपी लेड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हैज मेड इट्स बांग्ला विरोधी स्टैंड्स अबंडेंटली क्लियर by deliberately depriving people and abusing power to suppress Bengal's voice. They have made an array of hollow promises, disrespected Bengal's culture, and hatched continuous conspiracies to tarnish the state's image. Failing to fight us politically, you declared an all-out war on our rural poor, depriving them of roti, kapda, and makan. Sir, Honorable Finance Minister, gave a statement today in Rajya Sabha saying that Bengal has failed to implement the scheme that Central has aided in the last 10 years. Sir, I challenge the Honorable Finance Minister if she can release the white paper of how many dime, penny or rupees the central government has given to Bengal after its embarrassing defeat in the West Bengal legislative elections in 2021. Sir, in the last 3 years, let me put this on record. And sir, मैं कुछ बोलूंगा वो सही हो सकता है, आप उसके टिप्पणी करेंगे वो सही हो सकता है, गलत हो सकता है. सर, कागज तो झूठ नहीं कहता है. मैं बस इतना कह रहा हूं कि 2021 में आपने बंगाल में हारने के बाद आपने मनरेगा के लिए बंगाल में कितना पैसा दिया, और आवास योजना में 2021-22, 22-23, 23-24 फाइनेंशियल वर्ष में आपने अगर साबित कर दिया व्हाइट पेपर रिलीज करके कि 10 पैसा दिया है, 10 पैसा. सर देखिए, मैं व्हाइट पेपर मांग रहा हूं, ये चिल्ला रहे. अरे भैया व्हाइट पेपर दे दो, व्हाइट पेपर दे दो, कहानी खत्म. सर जिसके पास कागज नहीं होगा, सर व्हाइट पेपर मांग रहे हैं, सर व्हाइट पेपर मांग रहे हैं, चिल्ला रहे. इनके पास कागज नहीं है और पूरा देश से कागज मांग रहा है सीए का नाम पे. ये बीजेपी है, ये बीजेपी है.
आप बीच बीच में मत टोपिए.
सर मनरेगा फंड्स टू द ट्यून ऑफ 6,913 करोड़ हैव बीन फोर्सफुली विथहेल्ड, डिनाइंग वेजेस टू मोर देन 59 लाख वर्कर्स ओवर द पास्ट 3 ईयर्स. सर 11,36,000 एलिजिबल फैमिलीज have been deprived of a roof over their heads as 8,140 crore rupees under PM Awas Yojana have been deliberately halted. Sir, withheld the government withheld the release of over 800 crore under the National Health Mission due to non-compliance and certain color branding guidelines for health and wellness centers despite other conditions being duly met. Sir, despite 334 central and NLM teams visiting West Bengal in the last 3 years and ATRs being submitted on time by concerned departments of the state government against every observation that was made by the center, still no funds have been released. Official interactions with the Honorable Prime Minister and the other BJP ministers of the concerned department were met with dismissive attitude and constant rejection. Our leaders fighting for the people of Bengal were even detained in Delhi by Delhi police. Even women MPs were manhandled and dragged by their hair. And this BJP talks about Nadi Shakti. So the finance minister yesterday in a speech proposed flood control initiatives for states like Bihar, Assam, Himachal Pradesh, Sikkim and Uttarakhand, sir. Unsurprisingly, Bengal was once again left out, in spite of northern part of Bengal being one of the most worst flood affected areas. Despite 6 out of 8 MPs from PCs that falls under the northern part of Bengal being from BJP, this is the kind of discrimination meted out to our state. I hope people of Jalpaiguri and Alipurduar are watching this and listening to what I'm saying. The finance minister, as long as we stand as people's representative, the rights of Bengal's people cannot be taken away. The state government of West Bengal has already cleared the pending wages of 59 lakh Manrega workers from its own treasury. It has also been decided that the first installment of funds for the construction of houses shall be released by 31st December 2024, which is by end of this year. In 2022 and 2023, under the Pothoshri scheme, 26,486 kilometers of rural roads were constructed and repaired, and a financial outlay of 6,448 crore. Sir, depriving women, vanchit ho rahe desh ki nari, khule ghum rahe shoshan kari. You have 240 MPs in parliament. If you had implemented the 1/3 quota as per the women's reservation bill, the BJP would have had 80 women MPs. But how many do they have? They have just 31, which is a mere 13% of their total strength. And compare this to the Trinamool Congress, sir, which boasts not 1%, 5%, 10%, 13%, 15%, 20%, 25%. Sir, it has 38% women MPs in Lok Sabha. Last year, a special session was convened to pass the Women's Reservation Bill. Yet the BJP failed to implement it in spirit. In West Bengal, we demonstrated that where there's a will, there is a way. We achieved substantial female representation without grandstanding in the media. That's the difference. Sir, this government is depriving the students. Tisri bar, Modi Sarkar kho gaya hai siksha ka adhikar. Sir, the inability to conduct NEET is one of the biggest failures of this government.
Shame, shame.
Jeopardizing the future of almost 33 lakh bright students. India parties, we all of us in the opposition, demanded a discussion on this in parliament, but hardly a word from the Honorable Prime Minister on this issue. Sir, our CM wrote to the PM for scraping NEET in favor of reverting to a system where state government conducts their own medical tests. Sir, more than 12,000 vacancies in Kendriya Vidyalayas nationwide are yet to be filled in. Sir, more than 7,50,000 vacancies for teaching posts nationwide from class 1 to class 8. More than 1,20,000 vacancies for teaching posts in UP alone from class 1 to class 8. Students account for 8% of total suicide victims. More than 13,000 students' lives are lost every year because of suicide, sir. Sir, depriving the working class, depriving the working class, mazdoor ki jeb ho rahi hai khali, batao kab ye halat hai sudharne wali. Sir, ILO data reveals that the growth rate of real wages between 2006 and 2013 was 6%. So the data suggests that the growth rate of real wages from 2006 to 2013 was at 6%. Between 2014 to 2021 is down to 1.4%. The Indian Railways made a bold proclamation about upgrading 40,000 conventional coaches to Vande Bharat standards, turning a blind eye to the genuine struggle faced by everyday travelers, neglecting the fact that almost 96% of passengers journey in general and non-AC coaches. They continue to endure grave risks and vulnerabilities compounded by this government's sheer ineptitude. So now I come to G. G for guarantee. But a guarantee, but a, sir, khud bol raha hai, uska sarkar ka ghotala, sir, dekhiye. Sir, thank you. I would take that acronym. He's very good. Sir, G for guarantee, G for ghotala. Need ghotala and a guarantee with zero warranty. Sir, PM announced demonetization and guaranteed black money. Bhaiya, kitna self goal doge?
Hara diya tha to ek baar.
Kitna self goal doge? Dete raho. आपको ही डांट पड़ेगी. PM announced demonetization and guaranteed that black money would be wiped out. Sir, he failed. Sir, why I say guarantee with zero warranty? Why I say guarantee with zero warranty? Because PM announced demonetization. He said black money will be wiped out. Sir, this government failed. 99% of the black money came back into circulation and is in the system now. Sir, he guaranteed that terrorism would be curbed. Again failed. There has been 26 terror attacks in Jammu and Kashmir in the last 6 months. Sir, guaranteed to create 25 crore jobs in 2014. Failed. In 2023, the government admitted that in the last 10 years, only 1 crore jobs were created. Sir, guaranteed everyone will have a house. The Prime Minister himself said that everyone, every Indian will have a roof over their head. Everyone will have a house by 2022. The Finance Minister proposed the construction of an additional 3 crore houses under PM Awas Yojana. Yet no mention has been made of 11,36,000 houses in Bengal that are still awaiting central funds. While the same money is being allocated to purchase aircraft worth 8,000 crore and construct palatial buildings as a part of Central Vista project worth worth 20,000 crores. And the poor people of this country still endure homelessness and remain without a roof over their heads. Still remains without a roof over their head. Another failed promise. So they guaranteed employment to the rural poor under MGNREGA, but failed. As I said, not a penny has been allocated for Bengal in the last three financial years following BJP's embarrassing defeat in the 21 assembly elections. So they guaranteed to turn bullet trains into a reality by 2022. Failed again. Now the deadline has been conveniently shifted and postponed to 2026. Sir, 1 kilometer of bullet train costs 200 crore. 1 kilometer of dedicated freight corridor, DFCs on the other hand, costs 25 crore. Sir, railway accidents today has become the order of the day. But the union budget presented yesterday makes no mention of rail safety or installation of anti-collision devices or kavach in the passenger trains. Guaranteed to double farmers' income by 2022, it failed. Actual growth staggers at 3%. At this rate, farmers can expect their incomes to be doubled by 2035 or 2040. Over 1 lakh persons involved in farming sector tragically took their lives between 2014 and 2022. Around 30 suicides every single day. So they guaranteed that no home would be without electricity or water by 2022. So they failed again. They guaranteed to end terrorism. Failed again. More than 50 soldiers died in Jammu and Kashmir terrorist attack in the last 32 months. From 2018 to 2022, Jammu and Kashmir has seen 761 terrorist attacks and incidents, leading to 174 civilian casualties. You make all the big promises, but you fail to keep them. You give all the guarantees, but those guarantees come with zero warranty. Sir, under this budget, one thing is clear. The only thing that is growing faster than price rise and inflation is BJP's list of broken promises and guarantees. So we have B for betrayal, U for unemployment, D for deprive, G for guarantee. Maine bola na sir, ye acronym ki sarkar hai, to main acronym mein hi jawab dunga. To budget ka B tha betrayal, U tha unemployment, D tha deprive, G tha guarantee. Ab main E pe aata hu. Sir, E for eccentric. Modi ji has turned this government, or rather the governance, costing the nation dearly. Sir, his obsession with grandstanding and distracting the countrymen from the real issues, leaving India to pay the price for his dictatorial displays. Sir, he announced unplanned lockdown. The government's abrupt announcement of the national lockdown in March 2020 left citizens with only 4 hours to prepare, triggering a widespread chaos and hardship. So the unplanned and poorly implemented lockdown resulted in tragic deaths, over 8,700 people, primarily migrant workers on our railway tracks and roads. So now I come to farm bills. In 2020, the same Modi government unilaterally passed 3 contentious farm bills without any consultation with the farmers or farmer organization or any opposition party.
Please, isko record ko clear kar lo. Is sadan mein 5.5 ghante charcha hui thi. Is sadan mein kisan vidhek. Haan?
बिल पे कोई चर्चा नहीं हुआ है.
बिल
पे कोई चर्चा नहीं हुआ है.
किसान बिल पर
सर
जब स्पीकर बोलता है तो बोलता है और वो सही बोलता है.
सर बिल पे कोई चर्चा नहीं हुआ है. सर भाई उनका ताली बजाना खत्म हो जाए तो
नहीं नहीं पर माने
सर आपने ये सदन का याद दिलाया ना.
एक मिनट माने सदस्य.
सर आपने ये सदन का याद दिलाया.
माने सदस्य जब मैं बोल रहा हूँ तो मैं कभी गलत नहीं बोल.
सर आप मुझे एक चीज बता दीजिए. इस सदन में जो लोग ताली बजा रहे हैं, एक सेकंड सर, इस सदन में जो लोग ताली बजा रहे हैं, 700 फार्मर्स मारे गए, उनको मौत की घाट उतारा गया। सर एक मिनट, एक आदमी ने मॉनिटर, एक आदमी ने एक एक मिनट के लिए खड़ा होके उनके ऊपर श्रद्धांजलि दिया, ये आज ताली बजा रहे, इसीलिए ऐसा हाल है इनका। और सर 700 लोग मारे गए ट्रेजिकली ओवर क्या 700 farmers died. What did you do? You people have blood on your hands. You people have blood on your hands. In 2020, sir, this contentious fumbles get passed without any consultation with the opposition parties or farmers' organization. Sir, these bills. Sir, these bills sparked massive protests as farmers. Sir, मैं एक बात स्पष्ट कर देता हूँ, एक चीज सर, ये जो बोल रहा है, मैं बोल रहा हूँ बीजेपी से, मैं जो सवाल यहाँ पे पूछ रहा हूँ इनसे या मिनिस्टर को जवाब देना है, इनमें से कोई भी अगर जवाब देना चाहता है, कोई भी मीडिया चैनल चूज कर ले, मुझे टाइम बता दे, मैं आ जाऊंगा, एक हाथ लगे। मैं कह रहा हूँ सर, इनका दम है, इनका सीने में दम है,
आप अपनी बात कहिए,
और अगर हिम्मत है तो ये
आप चुनौती मत दीजिए, आप अपनी
बात कीजिए।
चुनौती मत दीजिए सदन में,
डिबेट विद मी,
ये बाहर चुनौती देना, यहाँ चुनौती सदन में नहीं।
सर हार्श मेजर्स सच एज बार्ड वायर्स, सीमेंट बोल्डर्स एंड आयरन स्पाइक्स were deployed on the roads to block farmers from entering the capital. This reveals the true face of this fascist government. Sir, demonetization. In November 2016, the Union government demonetized 500 rupees and 1000 rupees currency notes. Ostensibly, kya?
No,
you don't know that the demonetization was done in 2016. No. Sir, this government demonetized 500 rupees and 1000 rupees note. Sir, ये मुझ पे आरोप लगा रहे, मैं पढ़ के बोल रहा हूँ, पीएम टेलीप्रॉम्प्टर से बोलते हैं सर, प्राइम मिनिस्टर टेलीप्रॉम्प्टर से बोलते हैं, बेटा तो मैं पढ़ के ही बोलूंगा सर, अपना नेता को जाके क्या?
नो, नो,
अरे अपना नेता को जाके
नेता के बारे में चर्चा मत करो, आप अपनी बात कहिए, आप अपनी बात कहिए।
सर डीमोनिटाइजेशन वाज ब्रॉट टू कम्बैट ब्लैक मनी, इट वाज ब्रॉट टू कम्बैट करप्शन, इट वाज ब्रॉट टू कम्बैट टेररिज्म,
द
मूव रिजल्टेड इन अ सीवियर कैश क्रंच एंड सिग्निफिकेंट इकोनॉमिक destruction. Despite promises to eliminate black money, over 99% of the invalidated currency returned to the banking system, indicating the sheer failure of this initiative. So shockingly, counterfeit notes increased by 10.7% in 22, with fake 500 rupees note rising to 101.93% and 2000 rupees note by 54%. Sadly, 130 fellow Indians lost their lives due to heat and the strain of standing in long queues, falling victim to this eccentric decision. That's why we say E for eccentric. Now I come to the last letter. Sir, T.
Maanye
for tragedy.
माननीय सदस्य, आप वर्तमान बजट पे बोले 2016 के बाद तो 2019
सर, मैं सर
जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात लोग बोलेगा,
सर
जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात लोग बोलेगा,
कोई 60 साल पहले जवाहरलाल नेहरू का बात करेगा, दूसरे नेताओं का बात करेगा, तब आप कुछ नहीं बोलेंगे,
सब बोलते
हैं। मैं 5 साल पहले का डिमोनिटाइजेशन का बात करूंगा तो आप कहेंगे भाई वर्तमान निशुपे बोलिए,
बजट
सर ये पक्षपात नहीं चलेगा सर,
बजट पे
मैं बजट पे ही बोल रहा हूँ, जब बिप्लब देव बोल रहा था तब 100 साल पुराना बात कर रहा था, 50 साल पुराने इमरजेंसी का बात कर रहा था, तब आप चुप थे, और अब मैं डिमोनिटाइजेशन का बात कर रहा हूँ, आपको चुप रहे, वाह
वाह सर वाह,
बोलिए अपनी बात पे।
डी फॉर ट्रेजेडी एंड दिस इज द ट्रेजेडी, द एग्जांपल यू ऑल सेट इन द हाउस, दिस इज व्हाई आई से टी फॉर ट्रेजेडी। व्हेन द कोलकाता फ्लाईओवर कोलैप्स्ड फ्यू इयर्स अगो, मोदी जी जेस्टेड दैट इट वाज नॉट एन एक्ट ऑफ गॉड, ही सेड इट्स एन एक्ट ऑफ फ्रॉड। सर वी वंडर व्हाट ही हैज टू से when 141 lives were lost in Morbi bridge collapse in Gujarat, was it an act of god or act of fraud? Yes. Sir, what happened when roofs of Delhi, Jabalpur and Gujarat airports collapsed, was it an act of god or act of fraud? Yes. Sir, what happened when Ayodhya Ram temple roof starts leaking after the first rain, was it an act of god or an act of fraud? Yes. Sir, when Mumbai's Atal Setu, started developing cracks within 6 months of its inauguration, was it an act of God or an act of fraud? When 41 workers trapped for 17 days after Uttarkashi tunnel was caved in, sir, was it an act of God or act of fraud? When 20 people killed as a girder launcher collapsed in Samruddhi Expressway in Thane, what was it, an act of God or an act of fraud? When 300 lives were lost in Balasore, train incident last year, what was it, act of God or act of fraud? When 9 were killed and 40 people were injured as goods train rammed with Kanchenjunga Express last month, what was it, sir, an act of God or act of fraud? Yeah. Sir, the Rail Minister has blood on his hands. A once reliable mode of transport has been transformed into a death trap. Sir, 244 train accidents between 2017 and 2022, 15 major accidents in 2023 alone. Sir, 50% of compulsory track safety inspections were not even completed. Sir, only 672 crore spent out of the needed 58,459 crore on track renewal. Sir, Rashtriya Rail Sanraksha Koch, which would have received 20,000 crore every year, only received 4,225 crore. Sir, there's a shortfall and a staggering shortfall of 15,775 crore. Sir, Manipur is burning over the last almost 1.5 years. More than 200 killings, 70,000 displacements, 1,000 homes wrecked. Sir, no mention of the word Manipur in the union budget. Sir, another tragedy, of this government is weaponization of central agencies. Sir, another tragedy of this government has been the weaponization of central agencies to carry out politically motivated witch hunts against opposition leaders, like many of us, including me. Sir, they didn't stop at me or my wife, my elderly parents, my PA, my advocate, even my 11-year-old daughter and 4-year-old son were not spared. Sir, the BJP tried to make an example out of me by setting an example for the rest of the country to see, by letting ED and CBI go after me. Sir, but what did the people do? Desh mein janta malik hai, koi neta malik nahi hai. The people of Bengal and the people of my constituency elected me third time with a margin of 7,10,000 votes, setting an example for Narendra Modi, Amit Shah and the minions of BJP and the rest of the country to see. This is the people's power. Sir, if I'll have to bow, I'll bow before the power of the people. I will not bow before the people in power. This people needs to understand. Sir, India's national debt today stands at a staggering 169 lakh crore. The finance minister needs to know this. Before you ridicule Bengal for a debt of 6 lakh crore, the budget has predominantly, like I said, is anti-Bengal and anti-people. Even though the state elected 12 BJP MPs as compared to 3 in Andhra Pradesh, you still have the guts and gall to overlook West Bengal, and you will get a befitting reply again. Perhaps the central government would have benefited drawing inspiration from West Bengal budget for the year 2024-2025. Sir, our budget stood out for its inclusive approach, introducing new schemes while enhancing the incentives of the existing ones. It comprehensively addressed the needs of every section of the society, ensuring support for women, youth, students, fishermen, and artisans alike. By prioritizing equitable growth and social welfare, it has set a commendable example of governance focused on holistic development of the people. So, sir, I have explained to this august house, including the finance minister, who is sadly not present in the house, BUDGET. I repeat again, B for betrayal, U for unemployment, D for deprive, G for ghotala and guarantee, and E for eccentric, and T for tragedy. Sir, the finance minister made a seventh budget. The finance minister made a seventh budget speech. Sir, more empty words, more empty promises, hollow words. This budget has got more fiction than finance. I have exposed the track record of this government, sir, on promises, on governance, on guarantees, and on targets. Since we are talking about the general budget and estimates and figures, we should also take a look at the audit, or try to take a look at an audit. Sir, if you audit the results of 2019 general elections, what will the audit show, sir? The election results are a direct audit of the performance of the Honorable Prime Minister and this government. The PM was the face, the body, and the head of the BJP campaign, which cried, Ab ki bar, char so par. And what is the result of that audit? The result of the audit is BJP lost heavily in Bengal. They were stunned in Uttar Pradesh, shaken up in Maharashtra. Their slogan was, Jo Ram ko laye hai, hum unko layenge, backfired, sir. Okay. Their slogan of Jo Ram ko laye hai, hum unko layenge, backfired. I would rather say, Prabhu Ram aaye, to nyay aaya. Kuch waqt zarur laga, lekin insaaf aaya. BJP not only faced a humiliating defeat from the Ayodhya seat, but it also lost Badrinath in the last by-election. That takes me back from where I started. Waqt badal gaya hai. The Prime Minister now leads a creaky, vulnerable, shaky coalition. And it leads a coalition government which is just waiting to blow up. Rather than investing in the future of this country, it is unfortunate that the union government is investing for Modi ji's political survival at the expense of nation's well-being. Truth is, the Honorable Prime Minister is on borrowed time. You all are on borrowed time, mark my words. And I would like to end by saying, thoda sabar rakhiye aur kursi ka piti bandh lijiye, mausam bigadne wala hai. Thank you, sir.
माननीय सदस्य।